So as I told you, there are two types of ventilator. One is the bellows and one is the piston type of ventilator. Okay. So how does the bellows ventilator look? So this is how a bellows ventilator looks. So what is it? This is the bellows. It is made up of rubber. All right. Or any latex or latex-free material. It has to be latex-free. All right. This is the housing of the bellows. Okay. It is airtight. Which means what? And it is clear. It is clear plastic material. So we can see the bellows moving. Okay. Then there are two, connections which I've shown you. So this is for the fresh gas. This is not, I'll call it the breathing gas. I'm calling it fresh gas. Breathing gas. Okay. This is the breathing gas. Okay. And this is going to be the driving gas. Okay, so this is how the bellows assembly looks. Okay, this is, there are bellows can be ascending type or descending type. Okay, so what I have drawn over here is the ascending. These are the ascending bellows. So what will determine that it is ascending or descending? It is the expiration. Okay, it is during expiration if the bellows are ascending. That means they are known as ascending type. Okay. If during expiration they are descending, that means they are the descending type of bellows. Okay. So what I have drawn here is the ascending type of bellows. Okay. So what is the driving gas? So what is the role of this driving gas? So what happens is this gas enters over here into the bellows housing in which the bellows is placed. The job of this driving gas is to enter in and compress the bellows. So what will the driving gas do? It will press the bellows. And the bellows will, during inspiration, what will happen? The bellows will get compressed. Okay. What was within the bellows? Now see, now driving gas has compressed the bellows. Within the bellows was breathing gas, the gas that the patient will receive. So the gas that the patient has to receive now will leave the bellows and go towards the patient, towards the circuit. Is this understood?
No.
Okay, so now the driving gas which is there, which we are using, it is a gas which is going inside the housing and pressing the bellows. So this driving gas can be oxygen, or it can be oxygen plus air, or it can be only room air. Okay, so these gases are used for driving the bellows. Okay, now there are two valves which are there in a bellows assembly. Okay, so there is a spill valve. Okay, and then you have an exhaust valve. So what does a spill valve do? The excess breathing gas, this is going to release excess breathing gas. And this will release excess. This is how it works. Okay, so there is a spill valve. There are two valves, okay. One is a spill valve, one is an exhaust valve, okay? So the exhaust valve, if there is excessive drive gas pressure which is generated inside, the exhaust valve will release the driving gas, okay? The spill valve will, if there's excess pressure generated within the bellows while filling, so the spill valve will release the excess breathing gas. Bellows is also known as double circuit. The bellows ventilator is also known as the double circuit ventilator. Why is it called double circuit? Because there are two circuits of gases. There is a driving gas circuit, there is a driving gas circuit, and there is a breathing gas circuit. Okay, that's why it's called dual circuit. The pressure of the driving gas. The pressure of the driving gas is 45 to 50 psig. This is the pressure of the driving gas. Okay, 45 to 50 psig. Pounds per square inch gauge, psig. Okay, now we'll understand how this is a part of the circuit. Drawn over here, this is the bag valve switch. Okay, so you have two options. You go to the vent, this is the bag venti switch. Okay, so you either choose the venti option or you choose the reservoir bag option. Okay, so now we are understanding the ventilator option. I'll just explain over here what is this. So this is an incoming of the drive gas. Okay, So the drive gas will enter from here. Okay. There is another portion for the drive gas to leave, right? So this is also known as dual circuit. Okay. It's also known as dual circuit ventilator, bellows ventilator, bag in a house ventilator. Because there's a bag in a house. Okay. Dual circuit ventilator. Why? Because there are two circuits of gases which are moving. One is the breathing gas of the patient, which is inside. And one is the driving gas, which is driving the bellows, which is outside. Okay. So here, this is the driving gas. This driving gas is coming in. Okay. So it comes in and it will. So when the ventilator wants to give inspiration, drive gas will enter in. Okay. Then what is this? There is something over here. So this is the exhalation valve. Okay. Remember that there is a valve over here. Okay. So how we have APL valve over here for bags. There is an APL valve, right? Ventilator has got something called exhalation valve. Okay. There is a valve for the ventilator also. What is the job of these valves? That any of the extra gas that is there in the circuit, we have to remove it from the circuit. So from where it will be removed? From this to the scavenger. It will go, it will leave the circuit via the scavenger, right? So now, since we are understanding ventilator, we have to remember exhalation valve. Okay. So ventilator release valve. All right. So now we'll understand how inspiration is occurring. And these are with bellows. These are ascending bellows, right? Because inspiration, they are going down. Expiration, they are going up. And bellows are determined by their movement at the time of expiration. Okay. And so now we'll see how it happens. So this drive gas came in. Okay. Drive gas came in. Now what is going to happen? It's going to compress the bellows. Okay. So the bellows got compressed. Bellows got compressed and the gas from the bellows has to go somewhere. And we are doing inspiration. So we know that we don't want the gas to go here and leave. We don't want the gas to leave. Right. So where will the gas go? The gas will go here. The gas is going in this direction. So you can see the bellows has got two channels, right? And also the bellows housing has got two channels. Okay. So one channel is for drive gas to come in. One channel is for drive gas to go out. Okay. Inside the bellows also, one channel is for the bellows gas to go in and out. So this is going to be towards the circuit to go in and out of the circuit of the patient. And this is going to be to leave and go out extra to the scavenger. Okay. Now, because we have this exhalation valve over here, no? This exhalation valve. So it is sensing the bellows is compressing. Okay. Gas has to go to the patient. So this exhalation valve receives the message and it closes. Okay. It is closed. So what will happen? This exhalation valve will receive the message and close, and it will not allow the gas to escape to the scavenger. It will instead send the breathing gas to the patient. So who's sending this message to scavenger, to the exhalation valve? Who's sending the message? So it is the drive gas. So drive gas, you can see over here, it has got free movement here also and free movement in this direction also, right? Both the sides it can go. So driving gas is going on the left also, on the right also, and it is coming here. So what is the driving gas doing? It is sending the message to the exhalation valve that you close. So it will tell it to close. Okay. So drive gas has sent a message to exhalation valve and it has closed, which means what? Whatever driving gas is there will not go out and escape. Driving gas will all come here, press the bellows. Okay. That is one thing which has happened. Additionally, what has happened, that there is some dot which I have drawn over here. No? This, okay, I have drawn a big dot over here. So this is a pop-off valve. Okay, this is pop-off. Just remember there are valves. Okay, so there is one valve over here also. Okay, this valve, what will it do? It will not allow this gas, the breathing gas, to go to scavenger. It will send the breathing gas in this direction. So again, this movement is blocked. Correct? Even this escape movement is blocked. Okay. Now the inspired fresh gas is coming over here. It has entered the circuit. Now we know inspiration has to occur. So expiratory valve will be closed only, right? And inspiratory valve will open over here. Okay. The fresh gas came here via the CO2 absorbent. Okay. The breathing gas is coming, joining the fresh gas and going to the patient and inspiration is occurring. Now we will understand expiration. Okay. Now what has happened? Inspiration has gone to patient, right? Now we have to see expiration with the help of the ventilator. So now expiration will start. So the inspiratory valve will close, right? Okay. So now expiration has started. Patient, from the patient, it's coming towards the one-way expiratory valve. One-way expiratory valve opened. Exhaled gases are coming. Okay. Now where exhaled gases will go, they need a reservoir to store itself, right? And now I am using the venti, correct? I am using venti. So it will come here. It will see, okay, we have to go to venti. We don't have to go to bag. So it will go to the venti. All the exhaled gases went to the venti. What happened because it went to the venti? The bellows went up, ascend. Bellows ascended up. And bellows got full. Okay. Now what happened? Bellows became full. All right. Now, because the bellows want to become full, they need space, right? Previously, bellows were compressed and all the chamber was filled with drive gas outside, right? Outside, all drive gas was full. Now, if bellows want to expand, drive gas has to go somewhere, no? It has to go out, right? So now what will happen? Drive gas, which was there, no, over here, all collected drive gas, because the bellows have started ascending, drive gas is going out. It is going out, okay? And it is going to the exhalation valve, right? Now, all the drive gas that was collected over here in the housing, going to the exhalation valve will open, okay? Exhalation valve opened, drive gas left out, came out, drive gas went to the scavenger. That one thing we understood, okay? During expiration, incoming drive gas will not be there, obviously, because we don't want to provide a breath. So, but there was some drive gas which was collected in the bellows housing. That gas has now gone through the exhalation valve and it went to the scavenger. Therefore, the bellows have ascended and they have got filled up, okay, with the exhaled gases of the patient. But is the bellows getting filled up only with exhaled gases? No. So we know that your fresh gas is though a thing which will keep on going. It is a continuous thing, fresh gas. I cannot decide that I want to stop the fresh gas now, start it now. So fresh gas is going, but now inspiratory valve is closed, no? So during, what will happen? Fresh gas has no option but to go in the retrograde direction. So fresh gas is also going in retrograde direction. It came over here, reached the switch. Fresh gas got the message, okay, we are going towards venti because the switch is towards venti. So fresh gas is also filling. So now what happened? Expired gases have also filled up over here. Fresh gas also has filled up over there. Okay. So now what will happen? At one point, lot of gas will be collected in the bellows. Bellows cannot accommodate so much, right? Because now at one point, what will happen? Expiration is over. Patient, whatever expiration had to be done, the tidal volume expiration is over. So what will happen? Now this has stopped. This flow has stopped. Okay. At one point, this expiration flow has stopped and this expiratory valve has closed. Yet, before my next breath goes to the patient with the help of my venti, fresh gas flow is still happening. There is a pause, right? So that time also fresh gas flow is filling. Bellows cannot overfill now. So what will happen now? Because bellows cannot overfill, this pop-off valve will pop up. Okay. So now what happened? This pop-off valve, no, it will sense, oh my God, inside pressure is too much. Pop-off valve has sensed it, okay? Inside pressure is too much. Okay, so extra, whichever is there, no, extra, we will send it out. So pop-off valve is saying, we will send the extra breathing gas out. So from where it will go? Pop-off valve opened, breathing gas extra came here. It came to the exhalation valve, okay? And it went to the scavenger. So now, to the scavenger, what all extra is going? All the extra driving gas also left. All the extra breathing gas also left. What I'm telling you now, see this, bellows are requiring some drive gas, right? Which is coming in from here to push it. And so that driving gas is what? Oxygen, air. Now sometimes what happens, we are in the OT. Oxygen supply is less. We have less supply. So imagine you are using oxygen for breathing also. You are using oxygen for driving also. So we are wasting so much oxygen, right? If we are having a limited supply, only cylinder I have. My cylinder will get over only. So what I should do that time? That time I should not use the ventilator and I should come the bag. I wish I should bring the patient and I should manually ventilate the patient and I will save oxygen. Okay. Then one more point that we need to remember is that this bellows housing pressure, which is there, no? The bellows pressure. So see, this pressure within the bellows, right? Certain amount only it can accommodate. No, it cannot exceed. Right? It cannot exceed the outside pressure. So the pop-up valve I told you is opening. So what is that pressure at which pop-up valve is opening? So it is going to open at a pressure of more than 2.5 centimeter water. What I'm telling you, pop-up valve will open when this inside pressure becomes more than 2.5 centimeters of water. Okay. Means not absolute. It is exceeding the outside pressure. So inside pressure exceeds the outside pressure, outside the bellows pressure, by more than 2.5 centimeters of water. The difference is more than 2.5. That is the time the pop-up valve will open. Suppose I am choosing to use bag. Okay. So I am doing inspiration. Okay. I am manually ventilating the patient. So I press the bag. Now I have chosen bag venti option bag. I have compressed the bag. Okay. So all the gas will leave the bag. Okay. Now where it will go? Inspiration I am doing. So inspiratory valve will open. Okay. Inspiratory valve open. This is closed. Okay. Now because this is closed, where it has no option. So it will come here. Now, why are this? So you know, this is having exhaled gases mixture along with some fresh gases. So it's a mix, no? So CO2 will get absorbed. And now this is without CO2 gas without the CO2 that is coming in the inspiratory limb. Fresh gas is continuously flowing. So it is going forward, joining the fresh gas, going forward through the valve to the patient, and inspiration is given to the patient. Okay, done. Inspiration is done. Now, what about expiration? So now, this will understand expiration. Okay. So now what has happened? Expiration has started. Okay. Now I have released the bag. Expiration will begin. So now expiratory valve will open and the inspiratory valve has closed. So expiratory valve has opened and now gas is moving along the expiratory limb. Now gas came here. So, okay, bag venti, we are on bag. Okay, so gas is moving to the bag. Gas moved to the bag because gas saw that we are using bag now. Okay. Simultaneously, what is happening? This fresh gas, which is there, is still ongoing. It will never stop. Now, it cannot go here because this valve is closed. So, where it will go? In the retrograde direction. So, fresh gas also coming in retrograde direction. Okay. And now, the reservoir bag is full. Okay, by this point, what has happened? Reservoir bag is full. Patient, whatever tidal volume he had inspired, that has also expired. Now, there is the phase of, there's a pause. Okay, expiration has stopped. Expiration has stopped. And my expiratory valve also closed. Now, what happened? Expiration stopped, valve has closed. I have not yet given my next breath. Fresh gas flow is still coming. Fresh gas flow is not caring. It is still going on and on. It's still filling the reservoir bag, and the reservoir bag now, it's becoming very overfull. What has happened? It's become very overfull. So what will happen? Reservoir bag became so full, with full of gases. It became so expanding. It's expanding. APL valve we have, no. APL valve is there. It's a relief valve, like how we had this valve. Relief valve of the venti. So here we have relief valve for the bag. So this relief valve will sense that the pressure over here in this portion has become too much. So it will open. And what will it do? Extra gas, it will send it to the scavenger. Is that understood? Extra gas went to the scavenger. Now next we'll do again inspiration. So now we will do inspiration. We will compress. Again we will go and we'll give the next breath to the patient. See. Ascending bellows and descending bellows, we will understand a little bit. Okay. So ascending means what? It is rising up when it is filling. During expiration, there is filling of the bellows and the bellows are moving up. Okay. If my circuit is somewhere disconnection has happened, maybe here somewhere disconnect, maybe here somewhere there is some leakage, there is some disconnection. Okay. That means there is some leak. If that leak is there, will my bellows ascend nicely? No, they will ascend, half ascend. Might little only it might ascend. Okay. It will not fill up properly because there is a leakage, no? So it will not rise. Okay. What is it with the descending bellows? Now you understand. Descending bellows, what they do? During the expiration, they will descend down. Means what? This same diagram now, it is upside down. How descending bellows look? I will show you. So this is ascending now. Descending look like this. And this is the housing. So descending bellows are looking like this. Exact mirror image. Okay. So what is descending bellows happen? That they will descend down and they will fill up in expiration. Now if there is a leakage also, it will still fill. Why? Because of gravity it is descending down. It will descend down because of gravity. And it will yet it will fill. And what it will fill now? Leakage is there now. It will trap the room air and it will fill up with the room air. This bellows. So you will see bellows is going up and down. Okay, expiration is happening, coming down. Okay, inspiration is happening, it's going up. But do you really know how much gas is going to the patient, whether actually leakage is there or not there? We cannot know only. This you will get a visual clue that yes, there is something wrong. You know, that visual clue is not there. Okay, so what is there? That is why whenever there's a machine who is using descending type of bellows, for them, there is an alarm. There's a special alarm, CO2 alarm. Okay, so there's a CO2 apnea alarm. So that will sense the CO2 and accordingly within, you know, this, what is the CO2 concentration inside, and will alarm, the alarm will ring. This alarm cannot be disabled. Okay. Then what are the problems with the bellows that we can have? Obviously, leakage is one problem, right? If your bellows housing, if this housing is not fitted properly, it's not fitted properly, leakage over there. There can be leakage over here also. Within the bellows can have a hole and there may be a leak in that. Okay. So first of all, if there is a leak, if the housing is not fitted properly, what will happen? There will be pressure will not be generated within the house. So patient will not get proper tidal volume. Okay. Another thing, if this bellows is having a hole inside it, what will happen? Through that hole, bahar ka outside driving gas will enter inside the bellows. And the driving gas is what? Air or oxygen, right? And with so much pressure, 45 to 50 PSIG pressure it is generating over here. That pressure will enter into the breathing gas, breathing circuit. And patient might cause barotrauma, alveolar hyperinflation might occur. Okay. Plus, you might dilute it. Now, suppose I am using air over here as a driving gas. And inside I have set FiO2, oxygen concentration 50%. That will get diluted, no, with the outside air in case there is a leak. So dilution of that, inhalation agents can occur, dilution of oxygen can occur, dilution of anesthetic gas can occur. All right. So these are the problems. Then if this valve, venti valve is defective, there is also a problem. Means any part you can think now, complications, you have to think what all parts are there, what all complications can occur. Now, valve is defective. Okay, valve is defective, then what excessive drive gas will be there inside, right? Then if this valve is defective, it might go, excess gas might go to the scavenger and be lost. Pop-off valve is defective, again, excess gas will go to the scavenger. Instead of going to patient, everything is going to scavenger. That problem can occur, right? Pop-off valve got stuck. It got stuck. And then the expiration is happening. Bellows are filling. And your escape is not happening. And barotrauma happened. Okay. So there are valve-related problems which can happen. Okay. So we have piston ventilator. Okay. So, mechanically driven. Okay. Electronically controlled. Okay, and it is a single, also called a single circuit. Why? Because we are only having the breathing gas. Only breathing gas is there in this. There is no driving gas. That's why called a single circuit. Okay, it is operating how? How is it operating? Operation like a syringe plunger. It works like a syringe plunger. Just imagine a syringe. Okay, now, and they are hidden. We can never see them. They are hidden inside the machine. Okay, how do they look? Now see this. Okay, so I have drawn some parts. It is very easy. Okay, so here we have, this is the breathing gas. As I told you, it's a single circuit, means what? only breathing gas is there, no driving gas. It is all mechanical work with the help of this motor which is there over here. This is going to be pushing what? This is what? This is the piston. Okay. So this breathing gas is coming here and it is collecting over here. This is the breathing gas. Okay. I have drawn two things over here. What are this? So there is a positive, there's a pressure relief valve. So there is a positive pressure valve and there is a negative pressure valve. Okay. And the breathing gas is over here. There are two diaphragms. There is an upper and lower. And these are the diaphragms. Okay. Here we have the motor and here we have the piston. Okay. So you can imagine it like this. There is a motor and then there is a piston. So what will happen is motor now will keep moving it like this. It will move like a syringe. How we have seen the plunger of a syringe, just like that. Imagine this is the plunger of the syringe. Okay. So the motor is located over here and this fresh gas. So what happens now? Breathing gas has entered and filled it. Okay. Then when expiration has to, when inhalation has to be delivered, this will ascend up. Okay. So when inspiration is going to happen, no, how it will do? The motor will push it up. So what will happen? The motor will push this whole assembly up. Okay. So this whole thing gets pushed up. All the gas will also, so the diaphragms also move. Okay. Diaphragms are moving components. Okay. So diaphragms also have moved. Okay. So diaphragm has ascended. And now what has happened? The breathing gas will now, during inspiration, they will leave. Okay. It will leave. Is this understood? So this is the inspiration phase where the piston went up and whatever breathing gas that was collected over here left the ventilator. Okay. Next, when the inspiration has to occur, again, this will descend down. Okay. So inspiration, or when the expiration has to occur, so right, it has to collect the gas. So again, this will descend down. This will descend down. And now what will happen? The gas will come in. All the exhaled gases will come in and it will fill it. So this is how it works. So there is a positive pressure valve and there is a negative pressure valve. So what is that pressure valve doing? This chamber which is there, you know, which is collecting all the gas, it will sense the pressure within this chamber. If the positive pressure exceeds more than, it will exceed more than 75 centimeters of water, that means this valve will open and extra gases will go out. Okay. Sometimes what happens if there's a negative pressure generated inside? So how much negative pressure? -2 to -5 centimeter water. If this much negative pressure gets developed inside, this valve will open and it will trap in atmospheric air. It will trap in room air. Okay. So here now you have to see the location. Okay. So the piston valve is located here. The piston ventilator is located over here. Then you have something known as the fresh gas decoupler. Then we have the fresh gas, obviously, because this is inspiratory limb. Okay. Then we have the reservoir bag. See the location of reservoir bag. Okay. So, can you see these parts? Okay. So, the piston ventilator is not located, like, remember the bellows ventilator. Where was it? It was coming in the expiratory limb. Now, this piston ventilator, see, it's coming on the inspiratory limb. Okay. There is a fresh gas decoupler also, which is added as a new part in the inspiratory limb. Okay. You can see your reservoir bag where it has come. It has come in the inspiratory limb. Where was the reservoir bag that time? It was on this side. Okay. So see where, which part is located where. Okay. Reservoir bag is here, but APL valve is over there. Okay. So now what is happening during inspiration when we're using this vent, this piston ventilator? So this piston will rise up. Okay. Gas will go out like this and to the patient. Okay, fresh gas flow is still happening, right? So where will fresh gas flow go? This fresh gas decoupler was added. So what was this role of the fresh gas decoupler? What they realized, if we don't keep this decoupler, then this ventilator gas also will go, because ongoing fresh gas also will end up going in this direction towards the patient, and the patient might receive more tidal volume, more pressure ventilation, okay, which we don't want to happen. So that's why this fresh gas decoupler was added, okay. So now what fresh gas is going, it's going over here and filling up in the reservoir bag. So piston ventilators, what you will see that the reservoir bag, which is the outside, that is visual. You can see it, but you can't see the piston in many of the cases. So you can see that bag is movement. You can see the bag movement and you can understand, okay, the piston is also moving. Okay, because this is all within inside the system. All right. So this is the what is happening during the inspiration. And excessive, once the reservoir bag pressure is increased, again, this all excess fresh gas will come here, right? And it will go through the bypass valve, because now we are on the venti, we are not using the bag. Remember, although the bag is getting full, we are actually using the piston ventilator. So this will come to the bypass valve and then finally go through the exhaust valve out to the scavenger. This is during inspiration, okay? Now, what is happening during expiration? Now, expiration we'll understand, okay? So in expiration, now the inspiratory valve has closed, expiration has started, expiratory valve has opened, gas has come here, all right? Now, where will the gas go? Okay, so gas is going to come over here. It has no place to collect over here, right? The gas needs some place to collect, okay? So the gas is going to come here and fill up in the reservoir bag, all right? The gas is going to come here and it's going to fill up in the reservoir bag, and also the fresh gas still is coming and it is filling up in the reservoir bag. During the expiration, this is the way how it goes. And the reservoir bag gets full. That the expiration is occurring, expired gas is filling in the reservoir bag, fresh gas is also filling in the reservoir bag. Okay. Now, as we all know, at one point the expiration stops. Okay. So at one point the expiration stops, expiration valve will close. Okay. Expiration has stopped. So now this has stopped, okay? So now what will happen? Expiration has stopped, this flow has stopped. Reservoir bag is already filled up. Now fresh gas will come here and the decoupler will open up and it will allow the fresh gas to come in and fill into the chamber over here. The second phase of expiration, once this is over, now the fresh gas which is coming, it will now the decoupler will open and decoupler will now allow the collection over here. Before the decoupler was closed, now the decoupler is open. Okay, and this is present in Dräger Fabius machine. Which machine? This is present in Dräger Fabius. This piston type.